Hi and welcome to part 5 of the carousel blanket. In this part we make a border. We make round 1 up to round 6. We start the border in the first hexagon. The first hexagon is this color here, the blue one. We start here with the mustard and the spice color and we make the join stitches with the green cross color. That's the hexagon where we start. All the way around we make 6 rounds to complete the border, and in every round we use 16 different colors in total. I'll show you here after that I show how you make the stitches, what the color pattern is of each round. We start in round 1 with a new color on the hook and we start with a standing double crochet here in the top corner of the first hexagon. That's that green cross color. In that chain 2 we start with a standing double crochet, yarn over and you hook in that chain 2 space and make a standing double crochet. We go further into the next 23 stitches, make 1 double crochet, yarn over, enter hook in the first double crochet, that's after that chain 2 here, that's 1, into the next stitch and double crochet, 2, 3, 21, 22 and stitch 23, and that last stitch number 23 must be on the stitch here of the first double crochet of that group of 2 that we make in that corner space of the hexagon. Now we skip the next 2 stitches. That's the last stitch here for the chain 2 corner space and the first stitch after the chain 2 corner space of the next hexagon. Yarn over. You skip 1 stitch, the corners, skip 2 stitches and then into the next stitch. There we make our first double crochet of the next 23 double crochets in total. And that must be on the stitch of the second double crochet of that group of 2 double crochets that we work here in the chain 2 space of the next hexagon. Now into the next 22 stitches, 1 double crochet. That's 23 double crochets in total with your first double crochet here. That's 1, 2, 3, 21, 22 and 23, and that must be on the second double crochet here for the chain 2 corner space. You start here in the first corner, we go all the way down, skip 2 stitches, then we go all the way up, 23 double crochets in total, and now we go here in the next point. We make a color change. The next color is the aster color. We start with a double crochet in that chain 2 space, but we change from color in that double crochet. Yarn over, enter hook in that chain 2 space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull for 2, now you stop. We make a change of color, with the new color, that's the Aster color. With the Aster color, you yarn over a hook and pull through the two green pistachio color. On the back, you can make a little knot to secure a new color. And we cut off that pistachio color. With the Aster color, we make a corner. Make a chain two, one and two. And now go back in that same top corner space with one double crochet. And this here is your new corner. And this is only what we have to do. We start all over again after that corner here. Make in the next 23 stitches one double crochet, then we skip two double crochets, that's the double crochet for the corner and that double crochet here after the corner. One double crochet in the next stitch, and that's the first of 23 double crochets in total. Then in the next top corner space, you work one double crochet with the Aster color, and then we change to the next color. After that color change, 23 double crochets. Then we skip the next two stitches, yarn over, this is your first stitch, then we have here the two corners, and this is the second stitch. Into the next stitch, one double crochet, and that's the first of 23 in total. It's one, two. Double crochets. And now we have to change from color, and that's color lipstick. We make in the top corner space one double crochet, and then we change from color. Yarn over, pull your hook up, yarn over, and pull through two Aster color on the hook. Then with the lipstick, you yarn over and pull through the two loops of the Aster color. Make here on the back a little knot. And once more. Then we cut the Aster color. And then we repeat all the stitches from here. Down, skip two stitches, up, and make a new corner with a new color. Chain two with a new color, with a double crochet back in that same chain two corner space to complete the new top corner. And then in the next 23 stitches, one double crochet. Work like this all the way around, and you see now all the colors that I'm using in this first round, 16 colors in total. I'm working now with the last color of round one. We have to make on the end of this round one more color change. Here's the pistachio color, and this is the Parma violet color. We make one last double crochet in the first top corner space of the first hexagon where we start that pistachio color. In that corner space we make one double crochet and we change back to the first color, that pistachio color. The yarn is on the hook for the last double crochet here. then yarn over, enter your hook in that chain 2 space, the top corner space, grab your yarn, pull up, yarn over, pull through 2. Now go back to the first color, that's the pistachio. Now yarn over, pull that pistachio color through the 2 loops of the violet color. On the back I make a little knot. I cut the violet color from the blanket. I make a little knot. And only what we have to do with the new color, the last color and also that first color here, we have to make only in chain 2. 1 and 2. Now cut the yarn with a little bit longer tail to create an invisible join in the beginning. Now we have here the chain 2, open up that stitch and then we grab the needle and make an invisible join. At the same way, we skip the first stitch, that's the standing double crochet, we go to the second stitch, pull through, then you go back to the last stitch and that's the chain 2, the second chain stitch. You're in the middle of that V stitch, that's also that back loop of the stitch, then pull through. And this is your last and also your first corner. Wave all the tails in on the back of the stitches. And I wave the colors matching of the stitches. Wave all these stitches in on the back of the stitches here. And the color, the matching color, the tail in on the back of those stitches here. Also all the other tails. Wave all the tails in. I wave all the tails in. And this is the top corner space of the first hexagon. I mark that stitch. And in that chain 2 corner space, we begin with round 2. With a new color. You work at the same way that you did in round 1. You start with a double crochet, then in every next 23 stitches, 1 double crochet. Then you skip the next 2 double crochets here, and then 23 double crochets. Then we turn from color, change from color. All the way around, also 16 colors in total, and here's the list of all the colors that you have to make in round 2. I'm all the way around, done with round 2, and I make an invisible join on the top of the second double crochet. I place a stitch marker in this first corner, and this is the top corner of the first hexagon. This is the place where we start in round 3 with a new color on the hook. Also in this round you make all the stitches that you did before in round 1 and round 2 at the same way. 16 colors in total, and here's the list of the next 16 colors for round 3. I'm done with round 3, we are now halfway, 3 more rounds to go at the same way. Start in the top corner of your first hexagon with your new color on the hook. Here's the list of round 4. Round 4 is complete and we start with a new color for round 5 with a standing double crochet in the top corner space of your first hexagon. And here is the list, 16 colors in total for round 5. I'm done with round 5 and we start on round 6 with the new color on the hook here in the space of the top corner of your first hexagon. Here are the colors, 16 in total to make round 6 complete. And I'm done with round 6. This is the final round to make this border complete. We have to do one more thing and that's a nice edging around the border. But that's for part 6. Are you here for the first time? Then please subscribe to my channel. Click on the bell so you don't miss any new videos from me. Thank you for watching and I hope to see you next time. Bye!